The concept of mapping based on close reading of source text and deep interpretation of data, topographically non-obvious, has been increasingly reflected in recent years in theory and practice of humanities, including digital humanities. In this short paper, we want to present the Polish experience in this matter. I want to focus on attempts to apply deep mapping to digital literary research. That's obvious. And I want to focus on three cases. First, deep mapping in the digital literary studies and projects we conducted. I will present what we found our team, New Panorama of Polish Literature, which works at the Institute of Literary Research, Polish Academy of Sciences. What we found useful in the topographic literature research and what criteria we adopted during the selection. Second case, case of digital mapping Warsaw. Warsaw, which I find particularly difficult city in this regard. During the past 200 years, not only the names of Warsaw Street, the names of Warsaw streets have changed more than once, but also their course. For example, here in the north, you can see Nalewki Street, the one of two main streets of Jewish quarter, and then of a ghetto. This street exists no more. But now in Warsaw, we have Nalewki Street. I would say this is street which name commemorates the name of former Nalewki Street. And Nalewki Street nowadays is in a completely different place than pre-war and war. This is extreme case, but not the only one. So this makes difficult to use geolocation in digital mapping of history Warsaw. Finally, our teams work on maps in digital environment. So far has consisted on intensive collaboration between literary researchers, graphic designer, Agnieszka Zalocyńska, co-writer of my presentation, and a cartographer. So it's great occasion, it's great opportunity here to show how we collaborate. We are short of time, so I will present case study. It's our own project, but first, just two or three words about other important projects before ours. I would say that most important Polish scholars for our team personally are Jacek Lociak, who deals with Warsaw Ghetto literary mapping, and Dorota Siwicka and Marta Zielińska. They both work on topic mapping of romanticism, maps and Polish romanticism, topographical reading of Polish romanticism. We have real luck to collaborate with all of them. Our first major project, it was Atlas of Polish Romanticism, collaboration with Dorota Siwicka and Marta Zielińska. Then a case study I will show you. It's Atlas of Holocaust Literature, Warsaw Ghetto. During the project we collaborated, and we collaborate by now with aforementioned Jacek Leociak. I found the most prominent now Polish researcher of Warsaw Ghetto and Ghetto Literature. Another project was to word about it. It was project of Warsaw University. Topografię Warszawa pisarzy, Warsaw of Writers, four literary maps of Polish contemporary writers. They tracks in Warsaw, but also how they try to show Warsaw in their text. But let's go back to our case study. First stage we completed in 2019. Since autumn 2022, we are working on development on second edition of it. This is all the first stage. Okay, it combines all the key points I outlined above. It relies on close reading and deep interpretation of testimonies related to Warsaw Ghetto, maps topographically difficult city, that is historic Warsaw, the readings objectives and the difficulties involved in mapping historic Warsaw required adopting non-obvious solutions, how to put it on the maps, which involves close collaboration between researchers, graphic designer, and cartographer. As for the first stage, criterion of the text selection was the importance as historical testimonies and the rank in Holocaust research. So for example, we have testimonies by Janusz Korczak, Emanuel Ringelblum, Ludwig Hirschfeld, or Władysław Szpilman. If it wouldn't be so serious, I would say all the grades. Important was also the criterion of the time. Only text in the form of diary or memoir written during the war or shortly, just after the end of the war, were included. We didn't want to deal with category of memory. We know that things remembered after many years can stand in contradiction. Other testimonies can bring us the coordinates of place which never existed. They exist only in memory of the author. But however, it turned out that things aren't that simple, and I will show you that for a moment. First stage consists of 17 testimonies all from Warsaw. The key objective of project was close reading of a text. We didn't want to provide historical maps showing the most important places and events in history of Warsaw Ghetto. We wanted to show something we call the maps of experience. So we wanted to show experience of every 17 authors. Experience hidden in their texts. So during close reading of the text, researchers tried to identify all the topographical elements included in it. Then we had to choose signatures, how we can show this experience on the map, and then just put it on the map. To choose signatures. Sometimes we had to think it out. How can I? Okay. For example, here in the legend got two colors. First category is we. Second is they. We, this is my personal experience. I was there, I saw it, and so on. Second is to show the things someone had heard of, or the information gathered by our diarist. For example, yesterday someone showed Jakub Lejkin on Gęsia Street. We don't know if our diarist saw this, but he knew that, and we show it as second category, as A. Collection includes map that differs in scale accuracy, but this is our main basis. Map of Wurz-Łogetto. Maps were based on cartographic work of Paweł Wyszpiński. They are based on historical maps, but not only, they are modified by archival data. Prior maps of Warsaw not always are that detailed, as you can see. They are really detailed, location after location. We wanted it to be dynamic representation of changes of Warsaw Ghetto, and I'll try to show you it in a moment. Maps are key part of the data set we present in this collection. It's in combination with them where the text information about space found in testimonies becomes complete. This is, of course, not only key function. They also provide, as you can see, the basic narrative layer. This map is someone's story. In this case, story of Władysław Szpilman and his stages in Warsaw Ghetto. As you can see, here you got the whole story, but online you can choose period first, second, third, and fourth. For example, if you will choose second period, you will see only places connected with it. Another function is map is to map the narrative of the testimony. It had a huge impact of how we drew map and what signatures we have to adopt. And another function, map as a verification of data contained in the testimony. Here. This point is crossing Sosnowa and Czerna Street. But there is no such a crossing in testimony of Szpilman. In testimony, we find crossing Żelazna with Sosnowa. Żelazna is here, Sosnowa is here. They were parallel. So, as you can see, also in text written just after the war, that could be trouble with memory. So we try to show it in that way, but we are also working with cartographer how to show such data with signature. We hope to show it during second stage. Okay. Here you got combination map with the text. And here is a collaboration. So, graphic designer and cartographer working on signatures. How to provide it?
Comrade, just to ask for people okay. Online, if you can be by the microphone, just because the people online won't be able to.
Thank you. We tried to show also dynamics of being. So, for example, we have categories like road. You can see it in the map. someone was walking from point A to point B, we tried to show not only the street which someone had happened, not only the place, we know that something had happened here. We tried also to show situation. We know something had happened on the street, but we don't know exactly in which place. And the work, as you can see. I would say is the last thing I want to show. I wanted to show you a sketch because it was a question how to show experience which both is topographic and non-topographic. Spielman, during escape from Warsaw Ghetto, was lost. That's easy. We know that he was in ghetto. Then he doesn't know. He was escaping, he doesn't know where he is. And the end of this Z is a place where he where he was found. So when Agnieszka and I saw this fragment, I said, "Oh Jesus Christ!" And Agnieszka said, "Agnieszka didn't say anything. Agnieszka had drawn this, and this drawing, which was first expression, oh Jesus, how to put it on the map." Really was included on the map. It's hypothetical way he picked it. Thank you.